Ladies and gentlemen, can we please have a round of applause for Danish Seth and S.A. Arvind?
That lady that raised her hand three times, for some reason also, you're ignoring her?
I'm not ignoring you, ma'am. What's your name, ma'am? What's your question?
My name is Lucha. So, all three of you, maybe you can tell us, about your first crush in college.
Oh my god, that's a nice question, ma'am. Thanks, Lucha. I appreciate it. My first crush in college was...
Why college? Because I had in school, it's
school, yeah, you know, I had in school.
When I was born also, the lady who pulled me out, I was like, hi, doctor. You're female. I like you already. Dude, I remember, so I went to a boys' school. I've said this before. I went to a boys' school, and when you're trapped in a boys' school, you're just like, oh, ladies. You're really like, I you didn't understand, like, no woman ever spoke to me except my relatives and shit. And whatever. But so, the first woman I had a crush on in college was the first girl, this is all true. It was the first girl who ever spoke to me. I pursued her, by the way, for like a year and a half. I tried all sorts of things. By the way, girls, ladies, if anyone's young, is anyone like about 17, 18 or whatever in college? Who's in college? Always find a guy from a boys' school because we will do anything. Just, you don't even have to do anything. You just talk to us and we'll like make poems for you. I made poems where I would make poems which used to rhyme like you are my heart, give me a fart, like stupid shit, any bullshit. And I used to take it in a poster and burn the sides and put a heart in the center, like bullshit. Like I used to do so much. It took like 1.5 years and then finally I'm like, Kato, let's do. And she said, I have a boyfriend. So that was my first crush in college.
My first crush was during this summer class.
What is that?
Some like craft, arts and crafts and all that, no?
What is that?
Bro, son is 2.5, no wait, another 8-10 years and you're
no, but like in
there.
College you had summer class.
No man, not college, this was in school. I was in school.
Oh, you were, I was like, yeah. In college, why are you going to summer class? You're like, beta, today we make a pony. I'm 19 years old.
Yeah, this wasn't like, yeah, whatever, it was one of those places. So I met a girl there, fantastic dancer. Like even now I can actually like just, in my head, I can visualize her dancing. That's how good she was. So whatever.
Just one second.
I swear to God, bro. You know why. This story has an end. That's why.
How old were you?
I was about 12 or 13.
Okay, then it's fine. Okay.
12 or 13.
Because that's when it like starts happening.
Yeah, yeah. Just unbelievable dancer. Okay, like I can't get her out of my mind. Like that good. So at that brief point, we had actually gotten pretty close. Like whatever. Hi, hello, holding hands and all that stuff.
Oh. You know, after my loser story, they're like, holding hands, Adhika!
So, we held hands and all that stuff. Then summer class got over and that was the end. That's it. There was no contact again until about last year. Oh. I'm in Mumbai and I get a message.
That
saying,
was me.
Hey. No. It's like, saying, hey, do you remember me? And that name immediately had, like, it suddenly rang a bell and I was like, shit, is this her? And then I actually like I've never replied to anyone in that much of a hurry. So I replied back. She gave me her number. I spoke with her. And today she's such a big TV star in Bombay.
Who is she?
Nah, I'm not saying the name. I'm not saying the name. She's a very big TV
can
star
I guess?
In Bombay. You can.
It's Farah Khan. He's having an affair with Farah Khan. That is a true story. Shirish Kundar. This guy, if you see hovering around your wife, ask him what crafts he learnt when he was 12 years old. You know that thing where you make something out of scissors and you pull it up? That's his penis. He just go like, dekha, 12 aa gaye. That's how perverted Danish Seth is. That's a nice story. I'm sorry for ruining it with my bullshit.
He ruined it completely. Took away the whatever. Fucking sunshine, Bambi, you fucking removed all of it. Put our penis right there.
I've already said this, penis is ruined
like
everything.
My arts and crafts class seemed like that guy would come to school with that little one paper and scissors. Now, hello friends, I will do one cut, roses came, two cuts, flower vases came, one more cut, it has became my IK-47.
But that's a great story, man. Arvind, what's yours?
Better be more than holding hands.
No, it's very lame, man. I'll try my best to make it entertaining. It was 11th standard.
What was his name?
Danny said, but anyways,
was his name? Can I make a fuck all joke and then we'll move on? I mean, then you can tell your story.
Go ahead.
Was his name composition Arvind because you are essay?
Such an original joke.
I know, that's why I
never heard that before on me.
It's like people who call me panty, like it's the same shit. Yeah, please, so 11th standard, yeah.
Yeah, so the I'll try my best not to tell a name, but I'm pretty sure knowing me, I'll end up slipping it somewhere in this. This junior of mine, I could only hit on juniors because I had not grown tall enough. So I was the shortest one in my entire batch, so I had to look for 3 years younger ones. And there's a junior of mine, and back then MSN
was re-poverted, no? Re-poverted, this is like
damn creepy.
No, I'm
the younger ones.
You still walk around schools and all that.
Hey, I'm 11th standard, she's 8th standard, it's perfectly fine. Oh, what? So when I'm 11, when you're in 11th standard, you don't hit on a girl who's. So when you're 30, you don't hit on someone who's 27? So how come suddenly it's different in 11th and 8th and 30, 27 is fine?
11th and 8th, sorry, da. Politically sorry, da. I'm very sorry, I'm very disgusted. Sorry. Continue,
both of us didn't hit puberty yet, that's all that needs to go on.
It's so pure, it's pure, it's cute.
You were 11th means you were 16. You were 16 and she was 13. They're so disgusted, look at the face, she's like, 13.
What is it?
She's literally like, unsubscribe, aise Arvind. It's normal. I had boys in my school. Yeah, boys school. In my boys school, we had like teachers. We were like, ha, she's female. Like that's all we needed in life.
But I used to do stupid shit, man. And the guy I used to do stupid shit with is right here in the crowd. My best friend Bargo, he's sitting there somewhere. And yes. So what happened was that I didn't have the balls to actually go tell this girl I used to crush on her. So there's this thing called MSN Messenger back then. So I'd go to her ID and I'd chat up from my ID saying all great things about like how beautiful she is, blah blah blah. And then when I get, I'll try to figure out if she is interested in me or not. The minute I kind of figure that she's not interested, I'll sign out of my ID and I'll sign into Bargov's ID because I had the username password. Because back then, best friends amongst boys was like boyfriend girlfriend. So you have my password, I have your password. Actually, I didn't give him my password, I just had this. Anyways, but.
So then you signed
it. I'll sign into Baggy's ID, I'll go contact that girl on Messenger again saying, hey, SA is not a bad guy, isn't he? Have you seen how beautiful he looks? I do all stupid shit. And I mean, if at all he proposes to you, would you say yes? And the, if she's like, maybe, I'll immediately send him back to my ID saying, hey, I love you.
So did it work?
No. She found out that.
No, but I used to love that time because what used to happen was that every time you were trying to like get in touch with people, you used to say ASM. And I know this is a cliche joke, but I generally used to think it was asshole. I used to. So somebody was like, ASM, I'm like, no, I'm not.
I thought it was Assalamualaikum.
That's hilarious. But that's a great question, man. Rucha, are you with your childhood crush?
No.
You guys aren't together, only?
We are together, but he's my best friend.
That poor guy died.
There you go. This is your lady sitting with Bhargav. That's what's happening. Right there. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, can we have an applause for S.A. Arvind and Danish Sheth? Super fun, man. Thanks a lot.
If you enjoyed that video, go out there and buy my brand new novel, Pavan the Flying Accountant. Check out S.A. Arvind's YouTube page and definitely watch Danish Sheth in Humble Politician Nagraj in theaters now.
Hi, good evening. Like and share and subscribe to my channel.